In our number 5 spot in our top 5 Excel features, we talked about the use of left, right, mid, and trim functions to break up the contents of cells and extract data contained within them. We demonstrated a few simple examples for taking set numbers of characters out of a cell, but now we're going to show you a more advanced dynamic way to extract information when the number of characters you need to extract isn't always the same. A common example of such a case is trying to extract someone's first name and last name from a cell containing their full name. The length of each name is variable, so we can't just take a set number of characters from either end. We need to set up a more intelligent formula that will work out how many characters it needs. We're going to rely on the fact that the first name is always followed by a space, and the last name is everything after that space. The function we'll use here is called search. It returns a character number in a cell of a chosen string. So for example, here I've searched cell A2 for a space and told it to start from character 1. It tells me that the 6th character is a space. So now I can set up left and mid functions that use this information to extract the number of characters to the left of the space and all the characters that come after it, which are the first and last name, respectively. To compact things down, instead of referencing the cell containing the character number of the space, I can put the formula for finding the character number inside my left or mid formula, as shown here. Note that I had got the last name by taking 999 characters after the space. For a name, that's a pretty safe bet, but in general, you want to set it to take all the characters after the space, regardless of how many there are. I can do this using the len function, which returns the number of characters in a cell. I take, from the right, the total number of characters minus the number of the one with the space, as that's the number of characters to the left of the part I want to extract. This next example is a little more advanced. I want to get the region code from a UK postcode, which can be either one or two letters and sits in front of the code and is followed by a number. So I need to use a left function that knows whether we need to take one or two each time. Here we can see the breakdown of how this is achieved. First, I use a mid function to see what the second character is. Then I assess whether it's a number, which is done using the aptly named isNumber function, targeting the character in question. Note we've also used the value function, because even if the cell contains what looks like a number, it's probably stored as a piece of text in Excel, so value makes sure that anything that is a number is treated as such. So in our region column, I'll start a left function looking at the postcode. Now there are two options for the number of characters I can take, either the second character is a number, in which case the region code was just the first character, or it isn't, in which case it's the first two characters. To make a formula that can go down either path, I use an if function. The if function needs three arguments. First, tell it what your condition is. We can just say if C11, because Excel will interpret that as asking if the cell contains a true result from some previous true-false check, which is exactly what we have. The next argument is what to put in our cell when the isNumber result is true. Well, it means we need to only take one character from the left of the postcode to get the region, so we'll make it be the number 1. The final argument is what to have when the result is not true, which in this case needs to be the number 2 so that we take the left 2 characters. Altogether, we now have a way of always getting the right region code. Again, we can make it look smarter by replacing all the references to cells with the formula from those cells instead, meaning in the end the whole thing can be done in just one formula. Now we can extract the region code from any postcode automatically without having to correct cases where it took the wrong number of characters, as the logic for what number needs to be taken is encoded in our formula. The time spent setting up something like this is quickly made back in how easy it is to use and how much time it will save from now on. Hopefully these examples or further techniques will give you the power to implement these handy Excel functions in your own spreadsheets and start reaping the benefits they bring. If you enjoyed this video and want to check out more Excel, Access and VBA tips, then visit and subscribe to our channel or check out our website at software-matters.co.uk. Thanks for watching.